Hello students, welcome to Smart World, a school of complete education. Today we are going to learn the subject English, chapter 2.3, Somebody's Mother. Warming up. Question number 1. Read the following proverb that has a biblical reference. Do unto others as you would have others to do unto you. Which means, do the same things to others as you expect them to do to you. Now find at least 5 other proverbs, axioms, quotations which convey the same message. Search the internet or dictionary of proverbs. Question number 2. Study the following set of words. Set A, which has the words pleased, happy, joyful, ecstatic. Set B, which has the words letter, word, sentence, paragraph. Note, the words in these sets are arranged in an ascending order, each word showing a higher degree than the previous one. Now rearrange the following group of words in the ascending order. The first set is set A. The words are adult, aged, infant, youth. Set B. The words are cold, freezing, cool, chill. Set C, the words are brilliant, genius, bright, intelligent. Set D, the words are mountain, peak or summit, mound, hill. Prepare similar word chains using the following ideas. As rain is for drizzle, wind is for breeze, sunshine is for warm, water body is for pool, size is for big, size is for small. Prepare a similar word chains in the 3 columns given below. Here is a small poem named Somebody's Mother. The woman was old and ragged and grey, and bent with chill of a winter's day. The streets were white with recent snow, and the woman's feet with age were slow. At the crowded crossing she waited long, jostled aside by careless throng of human beings who passed her by, unheeding the glance of her anxious eye. Down the street with laughter and shout, glad in the freedom of school let out, came happy boys like a flock of sheep, hailing the snow piled white and deep. Past the woman so old and grey, hastened the school children on their way. None offered a helping hand to her, so weak and timid, afraid to stir, lest the carriage wheels or the horse's feet should trample her down in the slippery street. At last came out of the merry troop the greyest boy of all the group. He paused beside her and whispered low, "I'll help you across if you wish to go." Her aged hand on his strong young arm she placed, and so, without hurt or harm, he guided the trembling feet along. Proud that his own were young and strong, then back again to his friends he went, his young heart happy and well content. She's somebody's mother, boys, you know, for all she's aged and poor and slow. And someone sometime may lend a hand to help my mother, you understand. If ever she's old and poor and grey, and her own dear boy so far away. Somebody's mother bowed low her head in her home that night, and the prayer she said was, "God be kind to that noble boy who is somebody's son and pride and joy." This is a poem by Mary Daw Bryan. Guess the following using references from the poem: the setting, the region, the locality, the time of the year and the day. Let's understand the meaning of a few words mentioned in the poem. Ragged, which means wearing old and torn clothes. Throng, which means large crowd. Unheeding, which means neglecting. Hailing, which means welcoming. Lest, which means for the fear that. Lend a hand, which means help. English workshop. Question number 1. Pick out lines from the poem that help create images of the following in our mind and write them in the table. The table has four columns. The first column is number, the second column is old woman, the third column is street, the fourth column is schoolboys. You have to write three examples and fill in all these columns. Question number two. Write at least five rhymes from the poem. Question number three. Give in your own words two reasons for each of the following. A. The woman was reluctant to cross the street by herself. B. The schoolboys were in all happy mood. C. One of the schoolboys helped the old woman cross the street. D. We must help those who are in need. Question number 4. Think and write in 5 to 6 lines why most of the people on a street or road ignore those in need of help. What about you? Write about your feelings after you have helped or not helped when needed. Question number 5. Read the poem Home They Brought Her Warrior Dead by Alfred Lord Tennyson. Thank you.